Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone. I am Prasad Petiati, working as Data Manager for Cassava Breeding Unit at IITA Headquarters, Ibadan, Nigeria. Thanks, Lucas and team, for the nice introduction and sharing the information about different tools available on Cassava Base. Thanks for giving me the opportunity to share with you all how Cassava Base has helped IITA and other breeding programs to manage the day-to-day breeding activities and improve the data quality. As Lucas already mentioned, Cassava Base, which is an open access database, was developed under NextGen Cassava project in 2012 with the major goal of providing a one-stop shop for cassava researchers and breeders worldwide. This picture was taken in 2013 when Lucas was working with researchers from NRCRI Nigeria to develop the protocols for barcoding tools that are used to submit the data to Cassava Base. All NextGen partners started implementing Cassava Base for the core breeding activities such as trial design, phenotyping, sample tracking, etc., which helped to increase the efficiency in the activities, improve the data quality, and also enhance the collaboration across the partners. Cassava Base usage was not limited to NextGen project. Other cassava projects like Harvest Plus, 5CP, etc. started using Cassava Base as their primary data management system. Cassava Base helps to manage breeding data across all phases of breeding cycle, starting from crossing to analysis and selection. Cassava Base allows you to search the data individually based on accessions, plots, trials, locations, etc., and also by using a search wizard, which I usually call as a magic wizard, that was improved by Brian during 2015 by implementing materialized views. That has vastly improved the speed to query your data from the database across different data types. This is one of my favorite tools on Cassava Base, which I almost use every day for my data management queries. On Cassava Base, we manage breeding programs, locations, accessions, crossers, etc. Managing basically means adding, editing, or deleting. Cassava Base has different user roles. Only few experienced users from each breeding program are given submitter or curator permission that allows them to add or edit the data, which ensures Cassava Base will contain more reliable data. We also have Cassava Base test site, for which we give submitter permission to new users who want to practice all the functionalities. Any registered user are allowed to download the data in different formats. We use Cassava Base to design field layouts, generate field maps and barcodes for electronic data collections. Once the data is collected in the field, they are uploaded back to Cassava Base. Cassava Base allows to store the data in a folder structure for easy access. At IITA breeding program, we follow a year, location, etc. to store the trials. At Nakri in Uganda, they went a step ahead and storing them as a state gauge process as recommended by Excellence in Breeding platform. In cassava, after harvesting, because of perishable roots and planting materials, there is always a necessity for quicker selections of the best lines for advancing. Cassava Base have several analysis and decision support tools to help in the selection process. In cassava, large number of crosses are made each year. Hybridization deals with large amount of data collected, like female parent, male parent, date of crossing, number of flowers, number of bags, number of seeds, etc. Thanks to Tetima for developing the tools for managing the crossing information in Cassava Base. She made it very user friendly and generic so that it can be used for any other crop. We have started uploading all the crossing information to Cassava Base. So currently we are having crossing information from 2015 to 2021. We have also started working on capturing the seed information from our seed storage facility and planning to barcode all of them and start managing the seed inventory using Cassava Base. The data collection for crossing activity was laborious and error prone, as it was performed by a large team of specialized field technicians. Thanks to Trevor from Kansas State University for developing the Intercross app. We have initially tested this in Ibadan and Hawaii in 2020 And last year we have been implemented this in Ibadan and Ubiyaja, which are our major hybridization locations. It has really made things easier for us after using Intercross. All the data collected can be easily compiled together and uploaded back to Cassava Base. I have been giving training to different breeding programs on Intercross app and have seen good response. Not only on cassava, but like even other crops are showing interest to adapt Intercross for their hybridization data collection process. Plant phenotyping is an important tool to address and understand the plant-environment interactions. Phenotyping in cassava is resource and labor intensive, mainly for post-harvest traits because of the perishable roots and planting material. Cassava Base allows different tools to handle the phenotyping data efficiently, like designing the layouts, generating the barcodes, uploading the trial data in different formats. Currently, we have more than 5,400 phenotyping trials on Cassava Base, and you can see there's a significant increase in the data over years. So currently we have around like 18 million phenotyping observations in the database. Now coming to the genotyping data, during the first few years of the project, we had used GBS as genotyping platform. All the genotyping work for NextGen project was done at Cornell Genotyping Facility. The sequence data was processed using TASL pipeline, the SNPs were filtered using custom script, the missing values were imputed, dosage values were calculated, and these files are uploaded to Cassava Base for genomic selection predictions. After GBS was patented, we have moved to DART. Currently, we have been genotyping data for more than 42,000 accessions and for around 500,000 SNPs. The third generation HapMap for Cassava was produced at Buckler's lab at Cornell. The genotyping data can be easily downloaded for the required set of clones, both in VCF or dosage format. BTI team has continuously working on improving the genotyping data handling to make it more user-friendly. We have also focused on making availability of pedigree information for the accessions or clones on Cassava Base within each breeding program. So you can see the percentage of clones with the pedigree information from each breeding program. Once you have this pedigree information on Cassava Base, you can view them like a pedigree tree using a pedigree viewer. This pedigree information can be used for different analysis. Now we move on to quality improvement using Cassava Base. The quality management mainly deals with planning, quality control, and quality assurance and improvement. It's all about identifying any mishap or error that needs to be corrected, and after the identifying, we need to act and fine-tune the process to prevent those errors in future. So these are the different quality control measures we undertake to improve the quality, and most of them are directly linked with Cassava Base usage. I will try to cover these quality control measures in my next slides. Cassava breeding is one of the first adapters of electronic data collection, and now almost all the data is collected using handheld devices using PhenoApp tools. Cassava Base works closely with PhenoApp tools developed by Kansas State University that is used for different data collections. The PhenoApp tools uses the input from the files generated and exported from Cassava Base. The data is collected using barcode labels to ensure the quality. The most popular tool is Fieldbook, used in the field data collection. The Coordinate app is used for tissue sampling, and the Intercross app is used for crossing data, which I have mentioned in my previous slides. Genotyping trials keep track of the content of genotyping plate sent to genotyping facility. During NextGen phase 1, we had some challenges to match genotyping and phenotyping samples, as the software used for genotyping will not accept some special characters. All breeding programs has been using Coordinate app for genotyping tissue sample collection and tracking. And after the sample collection, these plates are uploaded to Cassava Base to track the correct phenotype-genotype match. Currently, we have more than 700 genotyping plates uploaded to Cassava Base from different breeding programs. these are the different areas where the barcode labels are used at IATA. We mainly use two models. One is slip-on tag, which is VLX1081SWH for regular field evaluations, and 2x1-inch sticky labels, that is CLPS1020SWH, for different purposes like genotyping, SAH, crossing, storing quality traits like Garian, Fufu, and starch, and etc. All these barcodes are easily designed on cassava base using customized label designer. We work on developing standard operating procedure for different areas of research. This is the list of SOPs developed from different breeding programs and are available on cassava base for global cassava community. We have experienced that SOP plays an important role as they help the breeding program to easily perform any specific task by following the step-by-step instructions. This is an example of NACRI protocol for phenotyping fresh cassava roots using ASD-QST and phenotyping boiled roots using penetrometer. These are the quality metrics across breeding programs. We go through them frequently to check the outliers of important traits, percentage of missing data, and metadata information uploaded for the trials from each breeding programs on cassava base. We can perform these metrics on cassava base using the analysis tools like BlockSpotter tool for detecting outliers. Percentage of missing data for all traits can be obtained from phenotyping summary statistics from trial details page, and the metadata can be downloaded from download page. We always try to improve on these aspects by updating the information. Under the Next Gen Cassava project, we have created a Quality Champs team who are go-to people for quality control and cassava-based related topics. These are quality leads and champs representing different breeding programs. They bring good diversity of people represented from different disciplines like research, flowering, database development, genomics, and breeding. Q-champs are the first contact person to seek help related to any quality issues in their respective breeding programs. They are responsible for handling and uploading the quality data into cassava base. The other important role is the capacity development, which requires regular training given to students, technicians, supervisors on data management, and mainly using cassava base. Excellent support has been provided by cassava base team with regular trainings, with very good online manual and some video tutorials and so on. The channels like Slack, Zoom, WhatsApp, etc. helped us to communicate better. All the code and updates are shared on GitHub. The number of BRAPI-enabled applications have been developed. The exchange visit have helped both cassava-based developing team and breeding teams to get a deeper understanding of the requirements and procedures. Coming to the capacity development, these are the different trainings we have conducted last 5 years on different topics like PhenoApp tools, cassava-based, quality control, and analysis. With the BPAT recommendations, we have been focusing our trainings not only on IATA headquarters but also for other IATA hubs and NAS partners to increase the usage of cassava base in their breeding activities. Because of the COVID travel restrictions, most of our trainings since last couple of years have been done virtually using Zoom. From user point of view, these are the reasons that I think which has made cassava base a successful database. This success has led to development of other crop databases like yam base, sweet potato base, and musa base. Not only from other crops, even the other projects working on cassava are using cassava base like RTB foods, cassava source to sink, and ground penetrating radar, etc. I wish and looking forward for the other projects working on cassava research like cassava whitefly, wave, Virka can also be benefited by using cassava base. I would like to acknowledge all breeders, data managers, supervisors, technicians, and students of cassava breeding team at IATA Hubs and NARS partners, and all the members of BTI team for the continuous support in developing cassava base, and sincere thanks to donors for supporting the cassava research. Thank you.